Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Juneja, and I'll be speaking on the novel panoramic OCT angiography, the non-invasive way of imaging the leakage in CSR, which is yet a diagnostic dilemma with terms of OCT angiography. So I would like to thank my co-authors, Dr. Manish Nagpal and Dr. Ahmed, and we have the financial interest from NIDEC for this study per se. So as we all know, the CSR can lead to the vision loss as it affects the macula. We use the age-old time-tested modality in the form of fluorescein angiography to identify the site of leak in order to know what's the area that is affected. But unfortunately, it delineates only the superficial layers, and this is what up to we are limited at the moment. So this is a new tool since down the line few years in the market now. And it is a novel tool that can that studies the images on the basis of principle of decorrelation and generates the microvasculature flow maps at all the levels of the vasculature, right from the superficial to the choriocapillaris level. So this is a paper in the journal where once the entire citation was done, that this study tried to identify the OCT angiography findings in CSR, but one could not exactly delineate the area correlating with the fluorescein or the ICG angiography, and henceforth was not very useful in terms of any treatment per se. So this is how what we get in an OCT angiography picture at the level of the choriocapillaris or a deep network, the areas which we yet cannot correlate with the fluorescein or the ICG angiography to use it as per se for our clinical standpoint. So were the areas that were demarcated on the OCT NG cubes in the small cubes were enough to understand the point of leakage? What was the underlying mechanism and the clinical implication of behind doing this non-invasive imaging? And what about the anatomical landmarks to be make it useful for the treatment per se? So this is how we generate the panoramic OCT angiography images. We identify a bigger cube, and this was the standard cube giving you a picture. And this is a comparatively large panoramic view at the different layers that what we are achieving. So after achieving these cubes, we tried to correlate our picture of panoramic OCT angiography with the age-old time-tested invasive tools, that is the FA and the ICG angiography. It was a single-center prospective study. 18 eyes were recruited, 10 had acute, 8 had chronic, and 10 were pre-treated and 4 post-treatment cases for a 6-month study period. The cases were diagnosed on the basis of OCT and the fluorescein. These are the baseline demographics. We included 18 eyes, as I mentioned. So this is a comparative picture of a fluorescein angiography with the panoramic OCT angiography. One could see that the area of leakage, the ink blot leak at the inferior arcade very well correlates with the dilated bulb-like tuft of choriocapillaris at the point of the choriocapillary network on the panoramic OCT angio frame. Similarly, the area of leak which was treated previously is also showing in the form of a thin regressed choriocapillary network, which was treated previously with the focal laser at this very point. Again, one more frame where we can see that the areas of the leakage on the fluorescein are very well correlating with the abnormal choriocapillary pattern, which was identified on the panoramic OCT angiography. Again, an area of leak correlating with the abnormal choriocapillary network at the level of the choriocapillaris on the panoramic OCT angio. So I'm putting across a few cases. This was an acute CSR, where one could see that on the fluorescein and the ICG angiography, the area of abnormality is very well being documented at the superficial and the deep choriocapillaris network in the form of the tiny dilated bulb-like abnormal choriocapillary pattern at the level of the choriocapillaris on the panoramic OCT angiography. So again, the second case where we treated this patient with the help of the focal laser, and one could identify that how these dilated bulb-like choriocapillaris got regressed at the very same location on the same frames. Now, this is the second case where one could see the ink blot leakage being documented on the deep choriocapillaris in the form of the same round dilated bulb-like choriocapillary abnormality on the panoramic OCT angio. So this is again one more picture where the patterns are again correlating at the very same location when you pass on the same frames. So this is the fourth case, post-treatment by the focal laser. One could see the area of abnormality on the invasive and the non-invasive tools at the very same location. You could easily delineate when you see carefully the this OCT angiography at the superficial and the deep capillaries. However, there are certain situations when you are getting the leak on the fluorescein, but you are not getting anything on the OCT angiography. So this happens because there is altered blood flow at the various levels. When we looked at the literature, we found that the CSR is a pathology where you will get the dysregulation of the choroidal blood flow also. It is not only the leakage or the choriocapillaripathy, but the blood flow is also abnormal, where the choriocapillaries are getting affected. And it is at many levels, at the superficial and the deeper, that has been proven in the literature. So we put forward a hypothesis that the various etiologies that are leading to CSR, they are causing an insult at the choriocapillaries, which has already been established. And with the leakage of the fluid, there is also a choroidal blood flow that can be documented with the OCT NGO. However, you need to be lucky that the dysregulation of the blood flow is exactly happening at the time while your scan is passing through. So it requires some experience to understand and to diagnose the leakage on this new tool. And when the altered blood flow is there, you can detect it. However, the sensitivity range is still around 70 to 80%. To our credentials, it was the first study of its kind to incorporate the panoramic OCT NGO in CSR. And it was a very novel, innovative way to detect the leakage and decide. And it carries the clinical implication that you are getting the landmarks for the future to try your focal lasers on the very same plane. So the invasive FA is still the gold standard time-tested modality you can perform in every situation, barring the nephropathy conditions or the pregnancy ones. Whereas the novel panoramic OCT NGO has a good correlation rate. It has high resolution images, provides you the landmarks, and in future will carry the clinical implications. So my take-home message is that the OCT panorama is a promising novel technique, a non-invasive and can detect CSR, and we are looking at the future of imaging and treating CSRs. Thank you for a patient hearing.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Rakesh, I think you have made an effort here, but I think I have one or two major objections. OCT angiography is not meant for leakage. Actually, leakage is not seen in angiography. That is the advantage, that the vessels don't get blurred. And the most accepted theory for CSC today is that there is dilation of the medium-sized vessels rather than the choriocapillaries, which in fact might have an insult. And the leakage is happening because of the RP disturbance. So I'm not quite sure what you are seeing there is actually happening at the choriocapillaries level or not. And some of the images that you showed, I think there was an overlap between the superficial deep and the choriocapillaries vasculature, and it was not properly segmented at the choriocapillaries level. But like you said, there is a lot of work being done on CSC and OCT angiography, and all these, I think, need to be looked into a lot in the future before we can actually say that OCT can be used as a treatment modality.
Sir, I appreciate your point. So as you rightly mentioned, we need to segment it right at the very levels of the superficial, deep, or sometimes at the vessels, what you mentioned. But definitely something is happening down the line. We need to identify by changing our planes, the area of segmentation, and it is the altered blood flow. As you have mentioned, the various studies that have been previously saying about the choriocapillary pathy, it is also the altered blood flow that is happening. We need to look at what plane it is happening. And maybe it is not the leakage, the word, what we are saying. What I mentioned was the abnormal dilated tuft-like choriocapillary or the choroidal vessel, what you can say, that is giving you the point where it is actually lying. So it is not on the FA, it is not happening at the superficial retinal vasculature. Definitely, it is at the choroidal level. So OCT angiography, once we try the swept source at a more deeper plane and we segment it more and more, maybe in the near future, we will be able to find out the leak non-invasively, and that would be very interesting to note, that to go from non-invasive from invasive to non-invasive in a real manner and to apply it clinically also.